I'm Alex Bell. Getting to the point and digging deeper into local issues, and we all know firsthand how the pandemic is changing how we live, and thanks to remote working, it's also changing where people live. So migration in Northern California during the pandemic has already changed Sacramento and the Central Valley, from home prices to even transportation and the state's representation in Congress. ABC10's Andie Judson has been digging into all of those issues, and a big question is, where are people moving and why?
Yeah, it's a great question. And put simply, people are moving here to Sacramento. And of course, that's among other places. But Northern California is seeing so much migration that experts are saying this area is becoming a mega region.
Sacramento is changing.
I have found Sacramento to be a really different place than when I was here last.
Just a hellhole.
You just think that it's kind of developing as a city.
People are moving here.
It was a good opportunity to come out here, kind of get out of the Bay Area.
As well as moving away.
I think it is time for me to kind of try to move somewhere else.
But a massive amount of migration is happening in Northern California.
But I was in the Bay Area the last 10 years.
Well, I originally came from like the North Bay.
Especially from the Bay to Sacramento.
So we had a decade of change in 2 years, essentially. Really. And an easy thing to point to is flexible work schedules.
The ability to work from home also brought the freedom to change where home is. In 2018 and 2019, pre-COVID, about 150,000 people left the Bay Area. When the pandemic hit, that number doubled, with nearly 305,000 leaving. It's just one of the shocking discoveries researchers found in a study conducted between UC Davis and two other universities that looked specifically at migration from the Bay Area to the Central Valley during the pandemic.
That includes communities throughout the Sacramento region, San Joaquin Valley, and the Sierra foothills.
Their interest came after finding that our region is melding together more than anywhere else in California.
Growing into one large mega region.
What they found is where people move depends on having easy access to where you need to go. Over time, whether it be a lifetime or multiple generations, people relocate further and further down highways.
For example, along Highway 80, people may again be living in San Francisco, but then move to Vacaville or West Sacramento, or continuing down Highway 80. People would increasingly move inland.
With the ability to work from home, their research found rather than relocating gradually along highways, many made a leap, moving to their end goal location.
Whereas someone might have moved from San Francisco to Sacramento to Roseville to El Dorado Hills, people were moving straight to Truckee.
That final destination always depends on their income.
Higher income households, much higher likelihood of moving to a place like Roseville or Folsom in the Sacramento area. Lower income households, much higher propensity to move to Stockton or Los Baños or Patterson.
It's why so many are flocking from the Bay Area inland. It's more affordable.
The average housing price in 20 years going from $600,000 to $1.5 million, that is a completely unsustainable rate of housing increase. The people who are coming from the Bay Area are in a sense being displaced themselves.
And the cities people are leaving, others are not moving to.
They're all losing.
Meanwhile, Redfin found in January of 2022, the Sacramento metropolitan region was the fourth most popular destination in the nation for people looking to relocate to.
This area, we actually have the space to build out.
This is obvious when you drive along Highway 50, where you can see home after home being constructed. Now, you remember that mega region? Well, it could be happening right here, as experts say that Folsom and El Dorado Hills could be merging into one.
The more multifamily, perhaps more townhomes, more condos of various sizes.
And we've already seen developers try to answer the high demand with townhome and condo neighborhoods like The Mill here in Sacramento, and these new homes here in South Natomas, and right here in Folsom.
In fact, investment buyers and developers bought 56.3% more homes in Sacramento in 2021 than 2020, a Redfin study showed. But a state audit report released in 2022 and based on numbers from 2019 said there's still not enough housing for the demand. In the Sacramento region, we're short over 153,000 homes, driving up the cost of housing in our area.
We're seeing more people who are being forced out, whether it's out of state or out of where they were living.
But another reason folks are moving away is because of politics.
And so when you see a demographic shift, we anticipate that we are going to see a shift in change of votership. So more purple rather than red and blue.
It's one of the reasons Bridget and her husband left Pollock Pines.
We're avid shooters. We like our firearms, but the laws are getting stricter and stricter and stricter.
She said the rising homeless problem, high taxes, and price of living sealed the deal on their decision. They landed outside Charleston in Orangeburg County, South Carolina.
You have so many more freedoms as an American.
She's not alone. An exit of residents over the last decade resulted in California losing a congressional seat in 2021, the first time this has occurred in the state's history. The U.S. Census Bureau found while more people left California than came here, other places like Texas, Florida, and Colorado gained a congressional seat with more people moving there.
I've been contemplating for the last 3 years.
It's what local business owner Miguel Frias is considering.
I'm a Sacramento native, born and raised.
But since the start of the pandemic, he's been thinking of making a move.
Last straw for me was just the way the whole pandemic was handled. And unfortunately, a lot of small business suffered heavy restrictions and mandates.
Others moving away didn't necessarily have a say in the matter.
It's easy to point to climate refugees in California who are being displaced by fire.
A growing concern is housing prices in desolate but fire-prone areas are becoming more appealing as people look for places to move for lower cost.
And due to climate change patterns that are really exacerbating our wildfire seasons, making them more intense, making them more frequent, that's really contributing to having people who have no place to go.
Wow, Andie, a lot's changing, isn't it?
It is, yeah, definitely. And how many people are moving away from California is evident in Life After California. It's a Facebook group dedicated to those who have moved or are considering a move. The group, created just 2 years ago now, has over 128,000 members. And we've been checking it as we go along with this report. It gets more and more members and thousands joining each week.
Wow. And so, Andie, all of this research, it really puts into context what a lot of us are already seeing. But how is this research being used to solve problems as well?
Yeah, it's a great question. Researchers are working with city and county officials, including here in Sacramento, to make recommendations for what they call interconnectivity between the Bay Area and inland areas.
So what does actually interconnectivity mean?
It's a very research-sounding name. And one of the big things it means is transportation. We don't really have public transportation like other big cities on the East Coast, but even something like California's bullet train may become a more popular idea as people move further inland, commutes to here from the Bay Area are getting longer.
All right, Andie, thank you so much. We appreciate it. And of course, we are continuing to follow this story. And if there's something that you want us to dig into, all you have to do is just email us at tothepoint@abc10.com.